heart of the Caterpillar Edwards Demonstration and Learning Center for a behind-the-scenes look at CAT Trial 10 Tech Test. I'm Deanna, and today I'm here with the people who made this all possible. Griff, you lead the tech recruitment team. Tell me a little bit about that.
So really what we're trying to do is double down all of our efforts at Caterpillar, along with our dealers, to show the industry and the public at large that we have a huge need for people to work in the skilled trades as CAT dealer technicians, but the construction and power industry at large. We need to make sure that everybody is focused on the doers and not just thinking that post-secondary education is the only path to success in this country, because there are multiple paths to do that.
As I look around at the course, the product lineup is pretty impressive, and there's a lot of different engines here today. Christy, can you tell me a little bit about that?
We brought a lot of different examples of our CAT Power products here, which is really exciting to see the iron sitting here. We've got everything from an on-highway truck engine to CAT industrial engines to marine power and CAT gensets. So really the whole realm of applications that are powered by CAT engines.
And engines aren't the only thing that the CAT dealer techs have to be well-versed in. The services are important too, and they had to match up a ton of different services on the wall. Jennifer, what kind of services do we have available that the techs need to know about?
Sure, we have a ton of services, from planned maintenance kits to SOS services to rebuilds to repairs. There are just a ton of services we have to offer, all including CAT genuine parts and all supported by our service technicians.
I think the victory lap at the end was critical. It was a great way to finish off the course. And Carter, you and your team were kind of responsible for building that. So talk to me a little bit about how you went about it.
So I got tapped on the shoulder and said, hey, you're in charge of the course. So be thinking what you want to do, how you want to try to make it happen. And one of the things, wanted it to give the feel of being maybe in a construction site where you're not going to be sitting on a level road driving through.
And I think when you were building it, you used rental CAT rental equipment too, right?
Yes, because you never have enough equipment for what you're trying to do. There's always that specialty equipment that we need, whether it's a light plant or a generator or air compressor or something, there's always rental equipment that we're needing.
Absolutely. And Layton, you got to take the victory lap. You got to go through the celebration phase because you were participating in the course firsthand. So talk to us about what that was like.
The course was really awesome. And to get here and to see, I mean, this entire course that's been set up and all the work that's gone into it, it was a really fun course.
And how were you selected? You're part of the Think Big program, right? And that's how you were selected to participate in that. Can you tell us a little bit about the program that you're participating in?
Yeah, so I'm part of the Think Big program, which really the Think Big program is kind of a double-edged sword. You know, you get the school and you get an internship. So you get the knowledge and you get the theory behind how everything works. You know, you get to take down an engine, measure everything. This is how we do rebuilds. This is how we look at a hydraulic system. You get to go through all that, and then you get to take your knowledge from that and go back and apply it in the real world with live work. And that is really where you do a lot of learning. We have mentors that help us through the program, and they definitely help a lot with the learning process.
Chrissy, you can talk a little bit about where do our dealer techs work and what does some of that look like for them?
Yeah, I mean, they could be working on a marine vessel. They could be on a job site in rental equipment. It could be going to a hospital or a data center to look in on CAT electric power and our gen sets that are providing that really critical standby power to applications like that. So the possibilities are really endless. And that's just the power systems side. Then you've got all the
construction industry sides. And that's why that training is so important, because in addition to the power side, there's construction sites, or really just at a customer site, just helping them troubleshoot maybe one or an entire fleet.
And the other beautiful thing about the Think Big program is that it's not just engine specific. I mean, we get to learn about electronics, which are, you know, becoming a bigger part of the field every day. Get to learn about hydraulic systems and all sorts of, you know, different parts of the industry. You're not just learning one specific thing. You're learning a broad variety of different components to the field.
I have to know, as you went through the course, the whole thing is amazing to me, but what was the most challenging part for you?
The most challenging part, I think not just for me, but from a couple other contestants, was the CAN test that you guys all saw. That's something that we do, or that at least I did, for my initial Think Big application. And I struggled with it then, and you saw that I kind of struggled with it now again. But that's a very good way to kind of get your foot in the door and to show that, you know, you don't have to have a certain part. It's kind of a monkey jumble of different parts that you get to put together.
And what, for those who don't understand the CAN test or know the importance of it, Griffin, what, tell us a little bit more about that.
So the CAN test is a way that we gauge mechanical aptitude for our technicians, and it's a widget, as Leighton had said. That is one challenge, too, is when they go through the interview process, they're just given a box of parts and a print and say, hey, figure it out. And that's pretty much what we did for the competition. With the competition, we made it a bit larger than life with CAT. So that's what we're trying to gauge when we have them go through the CAN test is, you know, can you look at that 2D image and convert that into a 3D product as well? Can you be thrown, you know, just a few things or a few bits of information and start to piece those bits of information together to tell a whole story?
Griffin, we've heard a lot about the different types of work that dealer technicians do. And this obstacle course was incredible and different than normal. But what do you really want viewers to know about the importance of dealer technicians?
One, they're awesome jobs with an awesome earning potential. You don't have to worry about college debt in a lot of scenarios because you're able to get to work right away. But the career potential is phenomenal. So I've had all these awesome opportunities because of my start in the skilled trades. Leighton's gonna have all these opportunities throughout his career because of the skilled trades that he started. When you have that expertise and that learning process that you build, that can be applied in so many things throughout your life. And I think that's where people kind of do a little bit of a misstep when it comes to the skilled trades. They think that skill set and those pieces that you're gonna learn is only for that job. But that stuff is transcendent over everything you're gonna do in your life.
And also, they're a trusted advisor to our customers. When we think about how they're skilled, they know our engines, they know our machines, these are who our customers are looking to get those recommendations on what they need to do to their machines to keep them up and going.
And no pressure, Leighton, but I mean, keeping these apps and products up and running, that's what the dealer techs do, right? And it really does fall in your hands. So what does that mean to you to know that you're in a position to make our customers successful?
There's a lot of pride that comes with this job. You know, getting a customer that brings a machine in, you know, that's broken, needs repair, getting to go through the troubleshooting process and getting to get that machine back and running and know that you've gotten a customer back on the road. There's a lot to say about, you know, being in a work environment that you can go home at the end of the day and feel proud of what you did.
You know, I think this course was challenging. Your work is challenging and certainly very meaningful. I thank you guys all so much for being here with us today. And for more information on the challenge and opportunities to be a dealer technician, please visit cat.com/trial10.